which is the most important theory. Tell me, what is hybridization? Anybody can define what is hybridization? It is a process of intermixing of. It is a process of intermixing of atomic orbitals. It is a process of intermixing of atomic orbitals having equal amount of energy and to produce resultant hybrid orbitals is called hybridization. So this hybridization classified into how many types? I was talking about types of hybridization. Types of hybridization based on the orbitals, atomic orbitals involved in the hybridization. Atomic orbitals, is it visible to you? Can you see what I'm writing on the board?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So here types of hybridization I'm talking today. So yesterday already I gave the introduction to this. So based on the orbitals involved in the hybridization. See, the types of hybridization takes place in the central atom of the molecule, we say. In the central atom, the valence orbitals overlap. What are these valence orbitals? It may be s orbital, 3p orbitals. What are the 3p orbitals? So you can take px orbital, py, pz. So s plus 3p orbitals intermixing, resulting to form the hybridization. First type is said to be sp3 hybridization. So the sp3 hybrid orbitals also number will be 4. So sp hybrid orbitals also number 4, and in this s character is 25%, p character is 75%, we say. Means hybrid orbitals. So these are the pure orbitals, and sp3 orbitals are hybrid orbitals, we say. Sometimes what happens, energy only sufficient for the intermixing of one s orbital, 2p orbitals. Then hybrid orbitals will get 3 orbitals, sp2 hybridization, we say. So here sp3 hybridization happen where means in the methane molecule. sp2 hybridization takes place in BCl3 molecule, example I am writing. Sometimes what happen, only one s orbital overlap or intermix with the either px or py, pz, only one p orbital. See, I am giving only one example, whether you should take px or py, pz. One s orbital, one p orbital, 50-50%. So intermixing resulting from sp hybridization, two lobes will get, example BCl2 we can write, or C2H2. What is the C2H2 molecule? Ethane molecule. Is that visible what I'm writing on the board?
Yes, sir, ethane.
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes. So here what I mentioned here in the hybridization, so s orbital and p orbitals are intermixing and resulting to form sp3, sp2, sp3. So these are the common hybridization types we see. But sometimes what happen, apart from this s orbital, p orbitals, 3p orbitals, 3p orbitals, okay. And d orbital also, d orbital, dxy, or dyz, dyz also intermixing along with these orbitals. For example, if one d orbital intermix with this p and s orbitals, resultant hybrid orbitals will be, how many here? These are 4, 5. sp3 d d1 sp3 d1 hybrid orbitals will get. And in case dxy dyz is involved apart from this d orbital, then it will be sp3 d2i. This is example PCL5 sp3 d2 sf6 example. And in case one more dxz, dxz is involved, sp3 d3 aega, sp3 d3, so like that we will get so molecules. So now we'll discuss one by one with by taking examples. Now I am taking the first type, sp3 hybridization. Sp3 hybridization, I am taking the example for the description. Sp3 hybridization example, already I told, methane molecule. As you know that methane molecule is formed one carbon, four hydrogen atoms at given temperature, at high temperature. So carbon combined with hydrogen to form, what is that? Methane molecule gas is formed, right? This is the reaction. That means methane formation doesn't take place at the room temperature. Methane formation takes place so at high temperature, okay? And now you can see, so here carbon is combined with four hydrogen atoms. The central atom of the molecule, what is the central atom? First notice the central atom of the molecule is, the central atom of the molecule is, central atom is carbon. Atomic number how much? 6. Then ground state electronic configuration, ground state electronic configuration, what is the ground state electronic configuration of the carbon? Tell me. 1s2, 2s2,
2s2, 2p2.
From this, notice the valence shell configuration. So valence electronic configuration is 2s2 2p2, represent in the form of degenerate orbital concept. Degenerate orbital concept we have to represent. So p orbital is divided into 2px, 2py, 2pz. And this is 2s. Here I am writing the electrons. 2s2 and 2px1 and 2py1, 2pz0. Is it right? So this is the ground state electronic configuration of the carbon atom of the methane molecule. Okay.
Yes,
so
sir.
And according to this configuration, according to this electronic configuration, ground state, so unpaired electrons only 2. And there are paired electrons are present in the 2s orbital. So as per this configuration, carbon only will make the two bonds. As per this configuration, as per the valence VBD theory, so carbon will make how many bonds? Only two bonds. But in the methane molecule, carbon has how many bonds? Tetravalent. Four bonds are present. So how come this possible? That means, so now we have to discuss excite state electronic configuration. So excite state of electronic configuration of carbon atom. So here generally what happened in the equation I mentioned, delta, what is the delta symbol? E. So if you supply the, when the heat is applied on this carbon, what happened means the electrons present in the outermost shell where in the 2s orbital gets promotion. So here in the excited state means electronic configuration, the electron present in the 2s orbital get promotion to 2pz. Then the configuration will be 2s 1 2px 1 2py 1 2pz 1. Yes, I think you got the 4 unpaired electrons 2s1, 2px1, 2py1, 2pz1. See, in the excited state of the carbon, electronic configuration is, what is that? Excited state electronic configuration of the carbon is, so carbon is 2px1, 2s1, 2px1, 2py1, 2pz1. After this, the hybridization process will start. So after this excited state electronic configuration, so what happened means the 2s orbital and 2s orbital overlap or 2s orbital intermix with 2px1, 2py1, 2pz1. So already you know the 2s orbital shape. Orbital is spherical in shape, right? This is 2s1 orbital having the electron here. Okay. And plus 2px, I'm taking 2px orbital, 2px1 orbital. Guess where could be the electron? The electron is here. Positive sign I am taking, negative sign I am taking here. Similarly, how many orbitals are here? P orbitals, 3. So here I am taking one more. What is this? This is 2PY1, and next one will be the 2PZ is perpendicular, no? This is 2PZ, 2PZ1. So now here 3P orbitals, 1S orbital with one electron each, they intermix each other. The resultant hybrid orbitals we will get. So four hybrid orbitals will get. See, hybrid orbital symbol is like this, we have to represent. This is sp3 lobe with one electron, sp3 lobe with one electron, sp3 lobe with one electron, sp3 lobe with one electron. How many equivalent lobes we got? How many are participating? Four orbitals, 1s orbital, 3p orbitals intermixing, resultant. See, and one more important, s orbital has little bit less amount of energy than this p orbital, almost all equal amount of energy. So producing the four hybrid orbitals, and these four hybrid orbitals tetrahedrally arranged, and between them the minimum repulsive force is present. So these are oriented in the space tetrahedrally, the four lobes, and during the intermixing, the electron present in the each orbital 2s1, 2px1, 2py1, 2pz1 are redistributed, and they will be reaching the, so at the end of these lobes. And now next, tell me what happens after this. So this, all these sp3 lobes, how many lobes? Four lobes are present in which atom? Carbon atom, right?
Carbon.
And this carbon atom is combined with how many hydrogen atoms? How many hydrogen atoms four. Surrounding this carbon atom? Four. So, and if you take hydrogen atom electronic configuration, so 1s1, no?
Yes.
That means So hydrogen having 1s1 unpaired electron need not to undergo hybridization here. So 1s1 orbital. 1s1 orbital is smaller than the 2s1 or not? 1s1 is smaller than the 2s1. It having one unpaired electron here. So yes. That's why all the hydrogen atoms with 1s orbital will pair up with the sp3 lobe. Will pair up with what means sp3 lobe. As a result of this, when sp3 lobe of the carbon combined with the s orbital of hydrogen, sigma bond is formed. One more sigma bond, three more, fourth sigma bond. How many sigma bonds are formed? Four sigma bonds. So then the bond angle is 109 degrees. Bond angle is so tetrahedral arrangement of the methane molecule. That means the carbon is the central atom. Means here carbon will make how many bonds? Four bonds. So one is below, other one is above. Two are in the same plane like this. Two are on the same plane. So one is below, other one is here will represent above like this. The bond angle is mentioned 109 degrees. Two hydrogen atoms lying on the same plane, but two hydrogen atoms are not lying on the same plane, above and below. Got it, everyone? Clear sp3 hybridization?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now yes, I'm moving sp2 hybridization by taking the molecule. What is the molecule? So I'm going to take BCl3. Now, second type is sp2 hybridization. In this, 1s orbital and 2p orbitals intermix. 2p orbitals resulting sp2. Example we write BCl3. Example we write C2H4. Note down the two examples I'm giving. So here I'm taking BCl3 for explanation. Right? BCl3, boron is the central atom. Its atomic number, how much boron? Tell me, what is the atomic number?
5.
Then ground state electronic configuration. Ground state electronic configuration.
1s2, 2s2, 2p1.
So as per this ground state electronic configuration, boron valency, boron will make how many bonds? Only single bond, no? Because 2s2 electrons are paired as per the VPD theory. So boron will make how many bonds? Only one. But as per the hybridization, it will make 3. That means, so boron, when boron combined with chlorine, how many chlorine atoms?
3.
3 chlorine atoms will form BCl3. So not at ordinary temperature. BCl3 formation takes place. So excited state condition. So that's why now I am writing EC configuration of excited state configuration of boron is. So here this is a valence shell configuration, right? That is 2s1 2p. So here I am writing degenerate orbitals. This is 2s degenerate orbital and this is 2p. This is 2px, 2py, 2pz. Now electrons present in the 2s2. This is 2s2 configuration. Already one electron is present in 2px1. Now energy supplied means what happened? Electron is promoted to 2py. Okay. So now here is the 2py1. 2pz0. Right?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Yes. Tell me.
Sir, it is already stable. Why it will give that electron to the last orbital?
Yeah, so see here, the boron is, boron here, this electron promotion is happening, electron promotion is happening during the reaction when the boron want to combine with the chlorine. See, boron want to combine with the chlorine, then only this electron promotion is happening, because in the boron there are no free electrons, no. Free electron only one.
Yes, sir.
So free electron means unpaired electron is only one. So unpaired electron is only one. But so how many chlorines are approaching for the boron? And if you look at the formula BCl3, how many chlorines are there?
Three
chlorines are there. No, that means boron is making how many bonds? Three bonds it is making.
Three bonds.
But as per this configuration, boron will make only one bond, because in 2s orbital there are paired electrons are present. As per the VPT theory, so paired electrons do not take part in the bonding. So the and one more also. How the boron will combine with the chlorine? How the boron will combine with the chlorine? Under excited state condition. Under excited state condition means, so we have to provide the temperature. During the reactions, we will provide heat, no? During the reactions, we will provide the temperature for the formation of the molecule, for the formation of the product. So that heat is helping in the promotion of the electron from the 2s orbital to 2p orbital. Now, the electron is promoted, you can see now 2s1. 2px1, 2pz1, 2py1. So there are unpaired electrons are present or not? So now here you can see in the boron, 2s orbital intermix with the 2px1, 2s orbital intermix with the 2py1. But 2pz is khali, na? 2pz is empty?
Yes, sir.
So one s orbital, two p orbitals resulting sp2 hybridization in the boron. sp2 hybridization in the boron. Then how many orbitals are intermixing? There are three. Then equivalent sp2 loops, how many aayega? How many you will get?
Three
only, no? Three equal loops aayega. And how these, so equal loops will be oriented in the space. See, now you can see here, this is the one sp2 lobe, here is one sp2 lobe, here this is one sp2 lobe. So this is sp2 lobe here, sp2 lobe. So where are the three electrons redistributed? Here is one, here is a one, here is a one. Now how these sp2 lobes are oriented in the space of the boron atom? With the triboron planar, bond angle is 120 degrees.
Yes.
So now hybridization, yes, deciding the bond angle. So hybrid orbitals are deciding the bond angle. So hybridization, the central atom deciding the bond angle. Clear, everyone?
Yes,
hybridization, the central atom is deciding the bond angle. So now you see chlorine atoms. How many chlorine atoms will approach now? Tell me.
Three
chlorine atoms. Three. So chlorine atom, atomic number how much? 17. Write the electronic configuration. 1s2, 2s2, 2pc, 3s2, 3p. 5, no?
5.
This is the outermost electronic, yes, configuration. So don't take this one.
Yes, sir.
3s2, 3p5. 3s2 is a filled paired electrons. 3pz I am writing. So 3p orbitals. 3px 2, 3py 2, 3pz 1. This is the configuration. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in which orbital there is unpaired electron is present? The chlorine. 3pz. So 3pz orbital are taking like this. 3pz orbital. This is the 3pz orbital towards the z axis. So having one electron this side. This side is a negative, this side is a positive, no?
Yes, sir.
Positive yes, means sir. Property of finding the electron. This side is 0, this side is 95%. So that's why this is the 3pz belong to which atom? Chlorine. So now 3pz, I am writing. This is 3pz of chlorine. Pairing electrons with this sp2 lobe. 3pz1 of chlorine overlap with sp2 lobe of boron, resulting one sigma bond. Clear everyone? 3pz1 of chlorine overlapping sp2 lobe of boron by end-on-end overlap. What kind of overlap this is?
End-on-end.
End-on-end overlap resulting sigma bond. Very strong bond. Similarly, another sp2 lobe of the boron combined with another sp3 pz1 of second chlorine combining with sp2 lobe of the same boron, resulting one sigma bond here. Yes. Similarly, sp2 lobe of boron making bond with the 3pz, one of another chlorine, resulting one more sigma bond. All these are end-on-end overlap. How many bonds the boron is making with the chlorine?
Three.
See here, I am not presenting here in the chlorine 3px2, 3py2, I am not presenting here. I am not representing here. Only the chlorine, which orbital I am representing? 3pz1. Imagine here is the chlorine. Imagine here is the chlorine. Imagine here is the chlorine. Where is the boron? Here is the boron. Now tell me, how does this molecule look like? What is the shape? What is the geometry?
Trigonal planar.
Trigonal planar. So that means BCL, BCL means three bonds are oriented in the space with 120 degrees bond angle to minimize the repulsive force between the adjacent bonds. Then the molecule is more stable. Understood everyone this BCL3?
Yes.
So BCL3 molecule, trigonal planar. So all the chlorines lying on the same plane now. Now third one, sp hybridization. Example for this, one s orbital, one p orbital intermix, resultant producing how many hybrid orbitals? Two hybrid orbitals. So sp orbitals, we say two sp hybrid orbitals. Example, can we write BCl2, C2H2, can we write examples? That means here one s orbital, one p orbital. One s orbital and two p orbitals having equivalent amount of energy, combining, intermixing each other and giving rise to 2sp hybrid orbitals. So this will take place in BeCl2. This will take place in that what means C2H2. The shape of the molecule will be linear now. Linear.
Yes.
Now I'm taking example BeCl2. So that means here one beryllium combined with the two chlorine atoms to form BeCl2. So now take the central atom. What is the central atom in this? Beryllium is the central atom. Atomic number how much? Tell me, atomic number of beryllium.
4.
4. Electronic configuration, ground state. 1s2.
2s2. 2s2.
2s2.
2s2.
Now, outermost shell configuration is only 2s2. 2p is 2p. Orbital is empty now.
Yes, sir.
2p orbital is empty. This is the ground state electronic configuration. So, here I am writing 2p orbital is empty here. So excited state configuration I am writing, excited state configuration. So since the 2s orbital having paired electrons, so paired electrons means, so there are no unpaired electrons. So that's why excited state electronic configuration is needed here. So that's what I am writing, 2s2. So 2s2 electrons I am promoting to where? Tell me where the 2s electron will be promoted. Where it will go?
2px.
2px, 2px, 2py, 2pz. Now the 2s2 electron is promoted to 2px. So now you can see here 2px. 2py is 0, 2pz is 0. Now possibility of hybridization between, so 1s orbital and 2px orbital, no? 1s orbital and 2, that means 1, this is a 2px orbital. Intermixing 1s orbital and this p orbital intermixing, resulting to form sp hybridization, right? So sp hybridization means, so 1s orbital and 1p orbital. This is 2px, 1, here is 2s orbital 1. So 2s orbital, 2px orbital intermixing, resulting to form, so sp hybridization we say, this sp hybridization, so I will draw now. So 1s orbital, 1p orbital intermixing, resulting to form, here is 1sp low, it is 1sp low. See, hybrid orbital representation, this is pure one, this is hybrid, symbol is here. Here is electron, here is electron. In this, so hybrid orbital, 50% of S character, 50% of P character will be present after intermixing. So here sp lobe, here is one sp lobe, here is other sp lobe. So this, now what is the bond angle for this? 180 degrees. How these lobes are oriented? In the straight line, like this. Here is one electron, here is one electron. Got it. So like this. And beryllium is combined with which atom? Chlorine atom, no? So already chlorine atom having unpaired electron in which degenerate orbital? So 3pz1. 3pz. 3pz. SP lobe of, SP hybrid lobe of beryllium combining with 3p z1 of chlorine, resulting sigma bond. And sp lobe of beryllium combining with the 3p z1 of chlorine, resulting sigma bond. So how does this molecule, this overlapping is taking place, means linear bond angle is 180 degrees. The molecule is appearing like linear. Everyone, here is the beryllium, here is the chlorine, here is the chlorine. So how does the molecule look like? Linear or non-linear? Answer Mila, sp hybridization is a linear. So in the central atom undergoes sp hybridization, the molecule shape is a linear. Understood everyone?
Yes.
So now how means fourth type of hybridization is sp3d1. In sp3d1, one s orbital, three p orbitals, one d orbital intermix. One s orbital, three p orbitals, one d orbitals intermix and producing sp3d1 lobes. So how many these orbitals? 1 plus 3 plus 1, 5. So sp3d lobes we will get. How many lobes we will get means there are 5 lobes we will get. Example is PCl5 molecule. What, which molecule? PCl5 molecule. Phosphorus pentachloride. Central atom of this PCl5, central atom of PCl5, what is that? Phosphorus. Atomic number how much? Phosphorus. Atomic number of phosphorus? 15.
Yes.
15 or not?
Yes.
So ground state electronic configuration. Ground state electronic configuration is? What is that?
1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2,
3p3. So find out the valence shell configuration. 3s2, 3p3, but 3p3, now write the represent in the degenerate shell. This is 3s2, this is 3p, this is 3s2, 3px, 3py, 3pz. Okay, 3s2 and in 3px1, no, 3py1, 3pz1. There are how many unpaired electrons are present in the 3p orbital?
3.
So 3, but in 3s2, how many paired electrons are present? 1 paired electron is present. Okay, so according to this ground state electronic configuration of the phosphorus, how many bonds does it make? How many covalent bonds does it make? Only 3. Am I right?
Yes.
But if you look at the formula, if you look at the formula PCl5, there are how many bonds are present?
5.
5 bonds are present. So how come the phosphorus will make 5? That means phosphorus will combine 5 chlorine atoms not at the ordinary temperature, not at the room temperature. So to form this PCl5, so require the temperature, no? Temperature needed or not?
Yes, sir.
Temperature is required. And now write the excited state. Excited state, electronic configuration of the phosphorus, right? Excited state,
yes.
Electronic configuration of the phosphorus. So we have to promote the electron from 3s to where? Where would the electron from 3s moving if you provide the energy to the phosphorus atom? Because already 3px, 3py having one electron each. So where would the 3s2 electron will be going? Tell me.
4s1.
So after 3p, which orbital will come? Tell me.
So 3d.
3d will come now?
Yes. Sir.
3d. So 3d, yes. How many degenerate orbitals are present in 3d? 1, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5, 3D XY, 3D YZ, 3D YZ. XZ,
Z.
3D X square minus Y square, 3D Z square now. These are the degenerate orbitals of 3D. So now, if you provide the energy, this electron from the 3S will be moving to the 3D. Here, 3D X, XY1. So, excited state configuration here is 3S1 aega and 3D XY1. So, I am writing 3S1 orbital plus 3PX1 orbital plus 3PY1 orbital plus 3PZ1 orbital plus 3D XY1. Intermixing. So how many orbitals of the phosphorus are intermixing to form the hybrid orbitals? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 orbitals are intermixing, no?
Yes.
Then equal orbitals, how many you will get? sp3d, how many lobes you get? 5 lobes, no? Equivalent number. So these 5 lobes, within the 5 lobes, 5 electrons are redistributed. 5 lobes are equal in terms of energy, in terms of electron distribution. So these 5 lobes, how these 5 lobes are oriented in the space? How much will be the bond angle? And between the, so 5 lobes, how much will be the bond angle? So now let us look that shape of that. So sp3d. So sp3d. So these are 3, 1 sp, 3d1, sp, 3d1, sp, 3d1, 2 lobes will be like this. So how many lobes are present? 5 lobes. 5 hybrid lobes. So here all are equivalent, but in this 3 lobes are present on the equatorial line. Here is 1 electron, 2, 3. So these 3 lobes are present on the equatorial line, on the same line. So these three lobes are present on the same equatorial line, on the same plane. Got it? And rest of the lobes are axial line. Means like this. So this is axial line. These are equatorial line. Okay. Here is the electron. Here is the electron. Right? Clear everyone? Now how much will be the bond angle? So and here is the 120 degrees. Here is the 120 degrees.
And 90.
One will be the 90 degrees. Axial to axial means so axial lobes will have the 90 degrees. Other lobes will be having equatorial one will be having the 120 degrees. Okay. So then the molecule this hybrid lobes will give the geometry trigonal bipyramid. Trigonal bipyramidal shape. What is the shape? Trigonal bipyramidal shape. So sp3d1 lobes, how many are there? Means 5 lobes, each lobe having the character, each lobe will having the character of S character, P character and D character. Okay, so now where would you place the 5 chlorine atoms? The 5 chlorine atoms see, each chlorine atom will come with which orbital? Tell me. To overlap with the sp3d1. So then chlorine atomic number likhna padega 17, outermost configuration 3s2 3p 5. So where will be the unpaired electron of the chlorine?
3pz1.
3pz1. So 3pz1 I am writing here. 3pz1 of the chlorine. 3pz1 of the chlorine pair up. 3pz1 will pair up. 3pz1 electron of the chlorine will pair up. 3pz1 chlorine will pair up. Yes. 5 chlorines are combining. That means sp3d1 of phosphorus will combine with 3pz1 of chlorine, and this kind of overlap is endolined, resulting sigma bond. Like that, how many are there? Like that, how many sigma bonds are found here? 5 sigma bonds. So now make the geometry of this molecule. How does it appear? Trigonal bipyramid geometry. Central atom, here is the phosphorus. Here will be the chlorine. Trigonal bipyramid shape. Mila aapko?
Yes, sir.
So perfect structure I will draw, PCL5. Central atom is here. Equatorial, here is the chlorine, here is the chlorine. 3 chlorine atoms lying on the same plane, okay. Here is the 4th chlorine. Here is the 5th chlorine. Trigonal bipyramid. See here, there are two types of bonds are present. Equatorial bonds. Number two is axial bonds. So here is question sometimes you'll get. The axial bonds of PCL axial bonds of the PCL, this one, are longer than equatorial bonds of the PCL. Why? The question, reasoning question, आपको आएगा. What answer do you give? एक क्वेश्चन आएगा आपको, द पीसीएल बॉन्ड प्रेजेंट इन द इक्वेटोरियल, दैट मींस हियर दिस इज द बॉन्ड, दिस इज द बॉन्ड, दिस इज द बॉन्ड आर शॉर्टर, दिस बॉन्ड्स आर शॉर्टर देन दिस बॉन्ड. व्हाई, व्हाट इज द रीजन? एक्सियल बॉन्ड्स आर लॉन्गर देन द इक्वेटोरियल बॉन्ड्स इन द पीसीएल 5. रीजनिंग क्वेश्चन आएगा आपको. So what is the reason? Simple, the Vesper theory will give the answer, because the axial bonds will experience the repulsion with the equatorial bonds. So due to the repulsion between bond pair, so the axial bonds are longer than the equatorial bonds in the PCL 5. They experience more repulsion. That is the reason. Understood everyone? Reason?
Yes, sir.
No.
That means here, so how these axial bonds are present, one above and one below, no? And so the axial bonds of PCL, this PCL and this PCL will experience repulsive forces with these three chlorine bonds, equatorial chlorine bonds. So as a result of this, PCL 5 axial bonds are longer than the equatorial bonds. Simple example, for this I will give one evidence. So why the bond difference is there? If you want to know the difference, the PCL 5 compound, when PCL 5 compound solid, if you take, upon heating, so what product do you get? Tell me. When the PCl5 compound upon heating, what products do you get? Can anybody guess? So we will guess. We will get the compound. Ek PCl3 aayega plus Cl2 gas aayega. So with this reaction, we understand that PCl5 compound having two different kinds of bonds, axial, equatorial. So equatorial bonds are stable than the axial bonds. Axial bonds are easily broken because of longer bond length is more. Got it everyone? Answer. When this PCl5 upon heating, so which bond will break up first? Longer one, no? Axial bonds are broken first.
Yes.
Clear? So this is the answer I would say, and so I think time up. There is one more molecule is left over, SF6 sulfur hexafluoride is left. So there